guys, it's Natalie G. Glam here. So today I will be doing the hashtag BOMB makeup tutorial, which is Black Owned Makeup Business. So this is really important, basically for our whole entire community, especially for us Black beauty bloggers, us Black girls that love makeup and just can't find exactly what we need. So I really wanted to try this out. I had to do my brows off camera because I couldn't even find a brow product to do that was Black owned. That just speaks volumes. Here in Canada, we don't have access to things as easy as it is in the States. And even in the States, it's still not as popular as it is, like, you know, any kind of brand. So if you think about it, like, a lot of people can just go to the drugstore, especially people that are not people of color, can go to the drugstore and pick up any kind of makeup that they'd like, and get their shade, and they're supporting businesses that, you know, are looking to, or are happy to have them as a customer, whereas they don't appreciate that there are a lot of Black women out there, or Black people out there that support their business, even by just buying a concealer, because that's all that they have access to, you know what I mean? So it just speaks volumes that, for me, I still couldn't find a brow product, I couldn't find a primer that a Black-owned business made. And even some of the products I use, they're not Black, I don't even think they're Black-owned, they're just makeup that was used to support Black women and that provided Black shades or shades that look good on Black women. So again, speaking volumes. So it's like, if you start supporting these Black-owned businesses, we don't know where it'll go, but I can only imagine that it'll go in the most positive direction, just because the more money you invest into something that's investing time and energy into you, it can only be reciprocated. So like lines like Black Opal that I'll be using today, they don't even ship to Canada, because I imagine it's not, they think that they don't have people out here that will support them if they get to be at, for a Shoppers Drug Mart or Rexall, or so I have to go buy it at the hair store because the hair store gets them. But it's just, oh, maybe one day they'll end up shipping to Canada, and then we'll have more Black women out here having some place where they can find what they're looking for, and we can support them back. So it's like, it was even tough for me to go and find things to do this tutorial today, but I'm very excited to try it out, because it can only go up from here, essentially, and that's what I'm really looking for, and that's what I really strive for on my channel, is to show you guys that we can do anything. And it's very important that this challenge isn't just for Black women, it is for us, our white friends that, you know, buy makeup and love makeup just as much as us, because a lot of Black owned businesses, they make still lighter shades. If you go on Black Opal's website, they will have fairer shades for white women. They might not have the palest pale for some of my friends out there, but they do have options that cater to people who are lighter skin, whereas we can go to the drugstore and we don't have that option either. So it's very important. I don't want to talk too much, I just want to get into it. But thanks guys for watching, and let's get into this Black owned makeup business tutorial, which I'm super excited about. So just a small disclaimer, just like Jackie, I will be skipping over things that I obviously couldn't find as Black owned. So like I said, my brows are already done, my primer will be already done, and it might just see like little glitches. But if you have any questions, just put them down below in the comment box, and I'll let you know what I did use. But here we go. So I'm taking my Black Opal True Color Stick Foundation and Rich Caramel. And I'm just going to clean up my brows with this using a flat eyeliner brush. out, I'm going to take the Black Opal Mosaic Mineral Mosaic Eyeshadow in Rainforest. And I just got this at the beauty supply store. It was like $5.99. Like, that's really not that much money. I'm taking this reddish color and I'm going to use it as a transition glue. Taking my Black Opal True Color Cream Stick Foundation in Black Walnut. And use this to contour. I just try to like find my cheekbone and carve it up and just like when I feel this is bone. There's no bone. That's when I stop. I used to do my contour all the way down here, and then I'm like, it looks weird on me. So it's, everyone's face is different, but like, look at how my lighting hits me right now. This would be the darkest point of my face, so giving me down here. Some people connect theirs to their mouth. That wouldn't be flattering for me, but having it here makes such a difference. And I am trying something new today, and I'm contouring first. I'm taking a NYX B7 multi-purpose flat top brush.
I'm gonna try.
You know when you do something that's a bad idea and you can also
it's not a bad idea.
Guys, what I was hoping to accomplish was that you can see that it's totally possible to do your makeup with a black-owned beauty brand. I know there was obviously some things that I couldn't have done or I left out. I just didn't have access to those things, which is fair. I also just thought of doing this tutorial today, so it was only what I could grab today. But things like highlighters, you guys know I like a really shiny highlight, and I was able to find a more subtle version of that. And I'm sure they have highlights. I just didn't want to have to go to the mall to go to the Iman counter and get highlight. But it's definitely something that is there. I'm still very happy with the overall look and the fact and the quality of the products, that I'm not suffering and nothing's lacking, like pigmentation, quality, like it's not, you know what I mean? These are still very, like, not high-end, but they're still very good products. And these are black-owned makeup brands that I use for my face today, with the exception of, I think, my brows and my primer, and it came out beautifully. So, like I said, there are tons for people who aren't black, and I tried to stay on the course of at least companies that I know, if they're not black-owned, they are geared toward people of color, because then at least it's still some form of support, because you can go to any place aside from maybe Sephora, but like any kind of like drugstore, and you see like basically white, and then off-white, and it's like, well, that's not really that great. And it's nice to know that we have black-owned makeup brands that are willing to put themselves out there to provide us with products that we can use, but they also still cater to people who are lighter skin. So all that we're asking is that white-owned makeup brands do the exact same. So to my white followers, subscribers, my white friends, white makeup artists, I still encourage you to challenge yourself and try out the black-owned makeup brands challenge, because they still offer those shades. So you are more than welcome and capable of doing this, and just putting a little bit of support towards black people. Like Jackie said in her video, it's a little bit chaotic in the world right now with things like Black Lives Matter and the things that we see every day on social media towards black people. So it's nice to have a little bit of positivity and just, you know that we're doing something that will at least help the community and at least uplift people in the community. So that's my spiel, guys. I hope you really enjoyed this tutorial. I know it was kind of awkward because I was talking and I wasn't talking. But overall, I hope you enjoyed the actual look. Products I used may be listed below, but also you can leave me a comment and I'll obviously tell you what I used. But this is it, and I'm so happy with it, and I'm going to try myself to use more black-owned makeup brands in, well, I use foundation, but in my day-to-day tutorials, like, this lipstick is, like, popping, and I'm really, really feeling it. And it's like, this is just when you put yourself out there and just try just a little bit, the things you find, right? The things you find. Well, thanks for watching, guys. Natalie G Glam. See you next Monday for my next Makeup Monday tutorial. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, and follow me on Instagram, Snapchat. That'll all be down below. Oh, and Twitter. And thanks for watching. Love you.